Hi everyone, welcome to Naresh Technologies. This is Srinivas. In this session, we are going to discuss about event listeners in a Sphinx application development. In a Sphinx application development, event listeners we are checking. So, first of all, what is a listener? In the last session, we have seen clearly how to create a frame. And next one, how to create components. The components in the sense buttons, right? Check boxes, buttons, text fields, labels, all these things comes under components only, but we discussed about buttons. So the same example I'll show you once again. Suppose the buttons frame we took, and here it is, we are declaring one button variable, either static variable or non-static variable is your wish. Suppose we make it a static, and here it is, we are setting the title to this frame, that is button frame, and with the size, width and height of the frame 600 and 600, and layout, I am not using any predefined layout like a flow layout, box layout, grid layout, we are not using. So here it is, directly I am using my own bounds. I want to set bounds explicitly. So that's why here I am specifying that layout equals to null, and I have given that button name. So click me, and I am adding, and we are setting some fonts. So where is the font class? Here it is available in AWT package. And where is the button class? JButton class is available in a Swing. So this much already we discussed in the last session. See, whenever we execute this one, it will show that button, but see, whenever you click on this button, there is no response. There is no response, no action of this button. See, listeners means what? Here it is, whenever you click on a component or whenever you are working with a particular component, it will react, right, to your event. So that's why we call it as action listener or event listeners. First of all, what is an event? What is an event? This event is an action. It is an action. Action performed on component. Performed on component. This is. So when action performed, what happens? When action performed, an object will be created with complete information, with complete information of event. That event object will be created. Inside, the complete details, event related details will be present inside the object and fires. Simply, as you are good at means what? Exception handling. In the try block, suppose if exception has raised, that will create an exception object and that will throw. So that we need to catch, we need to collect in the catch block to handle it. In the same way, here also, whenever you click on a button or whenever you enter the text into the text field or whenever you select that radio button, checkbox, anything. So when action performed on the component, an event object will be created and fires. So that we have to collect. Sir, who will collect? The listener will collect. Listener. So many listeners are there, but all these listeners are interfaces. Event listeners are interfaces. Interfaces. See here, a list of listener interfaces we are writing. One is the action listener. Next one, suppose, is a text listener. See, follows the naming convention rule. Text listener. And next one, it's like a focus listener. Focus listener. Mouse listener. Mouse motion listener. So many listener interfaces are there. All these are interfaces. Many listener interfaces are available. Sir, where all these listeners are available means what? These are available in available in Java package, AWT sub package. Inside one more sub package is there event. Event in a event package, event related classes as well as interfaces available. So all these are. Now by implementing this interface only, we can write the logic. Sir, in how many ways we can implement? How many ways we can implement? Implementing listener interface means what? In following ways. See, all these ways are very useful. Suppose if you are the Android developer, the same coding and the same programming we use in Android development also. So that's why. So be careful, right? It's very important. First one, directly with the help of frame class, direct implementation using frame class, J frame class, nothing but same swing frame class only. Second one, can be implemented by another class. Third one, can implements using inner class and using anonymous inner class also. In many ways we can implement an interface, but we'll see one by one how many ways. First we'll see direct implementation using JFrame class. See here, the same program we'll see once again. Is the same program we'll see here. Buttons frame is extending from JFrame, and now it is implementing a listener. What is that listener? Action listener. It is implementing same frame class only. Implementing, see, whenever our buttons frame class is extending from JFrame, it will get the behavior of JFrame. So our buttons frame also is working like a frame only, JFrame. Now so our current frame only is implementing action listener. See, implementing means what? It's an interface. Interface means what? It is having only specifications, nothing but set of abstract methods will be present. So definitely you have to override all those methods. Sir, if we are not overriding, you should make it as abstract class and then extension is required. But sir, action listener is available in which package? java.awt.event. In event, action listener interface is there. Now just compile, you will get one error. Buttons frame is not abstract. You didn't define it as abstract class and you are not overriding the specification which is available in that interface. What is that? Action performed method. A small letter, P capital. Action performed. See, it is representing that past tense. Action already performed. So after performing the action, this method executes. That's why they have given clearly action performed. And it is taking action event object as an argument. That action event object also, nothing but class also available in a AWT.event package only. So here, import java.awt.event.action event class we are taking. And here we are overriding. Anywhere you can override. Suppose interface methods are by default public and the method name is what? Action performed method. And it is taking what? Action event object as an argument. This is inside, we have to write the logic. Whenever you click on the button, automatically this logic execute. Here inside we are executing a simple logic, system.out.println. println, button clicked. Now just compile it and execute it. See, whenever you click on a button, still no action. Sir, we have written na? Yes. But remember, suppose here it is only one button is there. Sir, suppose if number of buttons are there, to whom this logic is belongs to? To which button this logic is belongs to? So, to that button, we have to add this listener object after implementation somewhere. To this button, we are adding action listener. We need to pass action listener object. Sir, how to pass action listener object, sir? Because action listener is an interface, na? Yes. But definitely interface we are implementing with one duplicate class name. See, yes, duplicate class name is there. What is the class name? Buttons frame. That is current class only. So here that buttons frame means what? Current class only. From the non-static area, if you want to pass current class object, this your intention is not passing this current class object. Your intention is passing action listener implementation logic. But action listener you are implementing with the current class only. That's the problem. So now just compile and run. Now look at this. Whenever you click on this button, click, executes continuously. How many times you will execute, and those many times it will execute. So this is just how to set listeners to a particular button or to particular component and all. In many ways we can implement. As of now we have seen direct implementation using the JFrame class, nothing but same class. Instead of that, by using another class like class, we can implement. And next one, using inner classes and using anonymous inner classes. Even in the Android application development also, event listeners we are implementing using any one of these four things only. So that's why, right, as a not only Java GUI developers, right? So this is very important for Android developers also. So thank you for watching. Hope you understood. For more videos, please subscribe to Naresh IT channel. Thank you.